In 2014, our per capita income was only 9% higher than the national average. So this just gives you an idea of how the bifurcation happened. So with this in the background, Mr. Naidu was sworn in as the Chief Minister in 2014, June. And we have to be among the top three states in India in per capita income. By 2029, we have to be number one in India, not only in terms of per capita income, but also happiness. And by 2050, actually compete with our Southeast Asian peers, Singapore, both in terms of per capita income and happiness. And this was the vision, a bold vision that he set way back in 2014. With this in the background, we actually sort of took this vision, like how Singapore does, but we broke it down into key performance indicators. So we have 962 key performance indicators across 32 ministries. And these key performance indicators are actually monitored on a quarterly basis. You know, it was a lot easier in school. It's quite tough now working for Mr. Naidu. So these are actually monitored, the tangible key performance indicators. And to achieve our 2022-2029 vision, as a state we need to grow at 15%. And we are now growing at 11.75%, making us the fastest growing economy in India. So it is possible. I know people keep talking, can India grow at double digits? Absolutely. Andhra should be growing at 15%, and we will get there. There is no second thoughts about it. But I think we just need to reimagine our governance structure and our methodology. So I think in Andhra Pradesh, we've used IoT in a very big way to drive in governance and quality of governance. So if you could think about a pyramid, and the bottom of the pyramid actually starts with what we call Praja Sadhikara Survey. It's PSS. PSS is actually powered by Aadhaar. Aadhaar is India's national identity program backed by biometrics. But what we have done in the state is to bring it into a family as a unit. Aadhaar is individual, and we've brought a family together. This has become the basis of government governance and delivery. It's really working for us. On top of that, we have something called e-Pragati. Loosely, it's what Singapore's equivalent of Gautech. It's tasked with unifying the various technology platforms within the various ministries and bringing all of them together and trying to achieve two distinct things. The first one is to create a single source of truth. And for all the Indians who are here, we know that that's the most difficult thing to do in India. The second is to create a certificateless government. You know, in a lifetime of an Indian, you know, the close to about 120 certificates that we accumulate, and that's the thing we guard the most. So if there's a fire in the house, the first thing you have to save is your certificates. Now we are actually going to be a certificateless government, and Aadhaar with your biometrics are going to enable you to access these certificates. On top of that is what we have built is real-time governance. A real-time governance center aggregates data from about 1 million IoT devices, the transactional data from e-Pragati and also from Praja Sadhikara Survey, and enables ministers to take real-time decisions. This is first of its kind. Each ministry has a person sitting there, and they give feedback to ministers and the principal secretaries and the team downward. It's, I believe, a complete change in the way governance is being done. This unit actually reports to the Honorable Chief Minister's office. So it's housed within the Chief Minister's office in Amravati. And the whole idea that the Honorable Chief Minister has been talking about is an outcome-based budget. Money is there. I mean, if you look at Indian state budgets, the pool is massive now. But we're not held accountable for outcomes. And using data to track outcomes and on a quarterly basis has really changed things. I'd like to give a few examples of how we're using the 4IR technologies in governance. The first one I want to talk about is big data. Natural resource water is plenty, but we plunder it. We take it for granted, not in Singapore, but in India. As a state, we are drought-prone state. So it's all about how do I use water efficiently. So we have now sensorized our entire river water network, our canal network. And we've removed political discretion in allocation of water to various districts. So based on the crop that's been sown, we know how much water, when was the last wetting, and we can give water accordingly. I'll give you two numbers. 17% deficit in rainfall, agri-allied grew by 24%. 1 year we had 24% in deficit in rainfall, agri and agri-allied grew by 17%. And let's keep in mind that India is predominant in agrarian economy. And we are staring at a huge agrarian crisis. Simple use of data and removing the political influence or interference in the whole process has brought about transformation. We are also using big data to sort of predict potential commodity prices. So we have done that in cotton as an example. We predicted cotton prices, GLAD, and we actually changed cropping behaviors within the state. So this is something that we do on a consistent basis. I think we just started. We are 3 years old into this journey, and there's clearly a long way to go. But I believe this is a way that I think India and different parts of the world can actually use big data.